So this is what, this was me when I was young and naive and artistic. So the case that I'm talking about here is bipolar disorder and depression. And if you notice that 2.3 million commit suicide worldwide at that time, so 14, what was the statistics? So in the past 45 years, there's 60% rates of suicide. Please don't ask me how I entered this case. I lost a friend because of suicide. So I decided to make a project for this to solve it. So 16 per 100,000 population every 40 seconds are gone. They commit. Wow. Beautiful wife. Connection is superb. So this is the project I told you that it had to be on hold for the last 2 years. It's because I was waiting for the AI engine to treat the data. So the reasons for the no-show patients, I think you guys know, is poverty. A lot of people cannot pay psychotherapy per hour. And there's hard access to clinical facilities. Not everybody's in the capital. Not everybody's in the cities. And the third problem is no data of improvement. You just don't know what's happening. Because it's staccato. It means that it's cut. The data is cut. It's not continuous. Right. I was really young. I made songs. The reason is that my friend, rest in peace, he tweeted his suicide note. So when he died, the nearest object he had is his phone. And he died because he was kicked out from the last semester of engineering because of a thesis. He was not able to pass a thesis. And since he had a lot of failure credits, he had to keep up. And because of poverty and a lot of constraints in life, he just decided it's time to go. You know, pressure, parents' pressure, family and all that. So when that happened, I said to myself, he tweeted, first he tweeted, right? Second of all, he died with a phone. And the third is like, why wasn't this condition known after all? He was really depressed. So this is the question that kept going on my head. And then I decided to make it an application, not a wearable or a hardware. So I speed off my own course, actually. Notice what I'm trying to convey here is that almost everybody is having a smartphone at that time, so 14. And actually, if everybody is connected to their phone, why don't we make an application which is offline, not really online? All you need to do is just install, and you have your own AI. So it's simulation. As you know, you remember what I said, take the medical practice and then spin that off, right? So it is a technique, actually, right? So you put your medications. This was the first version. And then you input your feeling status, which is the neurocognitive data. Because neurocognitive means that what do you think is your feeling right now? Okay. And then that will become, that data is put into the medication tablet. And then you can send it to Gmail, Facebook, doctor. Oh, yeah. So the other part is that I made it really, really simple because it's a research, it's not meant for commercial. So the other part here is the color mood. Instead of telling you what you think your mood right now, we just tell you choose a color. Because in psychology, there is a chromotherapy where every color has a meaning and has interpretation. So we wanted raw data. You see, medical data can be biased, especially the one from the mind, because you really think that you're feeling great, but the truth, you're just hypomanic, or you took too much drugs on that certain intake. So we wanted to have raw data. So we have to trick the patient somehow. So you choose a color, and then you reinforce what you think is the precise meaning. And that is put with it. And that's all data, 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 you see? I had a problem in maximizing, sorry guys. That was my problem. I didn't have time. So if no access to psychologist, you can have the AI doctor. And it's 24/7 ongoing because the expert system is simulating the CBT. And it's using the knowledge base, which we actually kind of started hard coding it because there was no library out there. There was nothing there. So we had to take books and get all the trigger words of every condition and put it into a library. So it recognizes highly emotional trigger words used by people suffering from psychological disorders, and these trigger words were brought from psychology books and psychologists themselves. So you actually classify your data. We made, so not learning, because we not yet learning, I told you I lacked the data, but we made supervised classification for the expert system to have a proper decision role. So it tells, oh, you're using the word suffering, so it's a high treatment. So it talks to you in that level to calm you down. Yeah. So that was it. Okay. I think I'm going to stop so that you won't feel that old. This is too. Okay, let's go here. One question for you guys is related to MR or scope. So how can we be part of this technical renaissance? Because this is technical renaissance. You see, we are at the verge by which we are merging. It's like the time, if you remember, in Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, where the church and science was having this beautiful tango, because there was like, there's art, and then there is order, right? Now this is a technical renaissance, because we're seeing mobile phones almost penetrating everything. So the question is, since we have a good diverse teams here, what can you be part of this technical renaissance? How can you together as order, which is an institutional, medical, hardcore, classical, with engineering, which is supposed to be an innovation, and business entrepreneurship, which is the backbone for the state to keep running, right? So this is the question I have for you, and this is why I told you guys to be in notes. So now it's time for you to be in your notes, okay? Can you please go back to your groups? Where are your groups? And so please tell us each node, what is your problem, okay? And please take 15 minutes, is that okay with you guys, to come up with a solution with whatever we have given you, from the gamification to the automated processing, the artificial intelligence. How are you gonna approach to solve this problem, all right? Mr. Neurosurgeon, can you please introduce yourself and the problem?
I'm Gurmeet. I work in Hospital Kuala Lumpur. The pain statement, the pain problem is, whenever you get admitted to hospital, you will be interrupted at regular schedules to have your blood pressure, pulse, temperature, respiratory rate taken. Hence, if you go to sleep and you're not well, do remember that's why you came to hospital. So at 9, 10, 11, 12, the nurses come again, wake you up, fix the blood pressure monitor, put the cap, get your pulse oximeter and all that data. Subsequently, at 4, you'll be woken up again. You're deep in sleep. Do remember you come to recover, and she'll be disturbed again. Fact number one. Fact number two, I speak from the nurse's perspective. She's got many patients. Do remember again, I come from a general hospital, government hospital, where there is shortage of staff. So she has to do so many things, she cannot focus on the ill patient. So she misses something and patient deteriorates. So that's two pin statements. Okay. Yeah.
So we're gonna give you 15 minutes, and please, the engineers and business developers here, please make ideation product, okay? Not really a product itself, but the idea of a product that could solve this problem. If you remember what we've been talking about, how to gamify certain things or how to use AI in certain things, all right? Good, that's the mechanics of the game. Okay, cool, go ahead. Where is the next node?
Hi, I'm Shafa Aziz. So I run a hearing audiology business. So I see patients with hearing impairment, vertigo and tinnitus. But the pain that I'm going to share with you is I see patients with vertigo. So we do assessment and rehabilitation, but when they go home, they still have to do home rehab exercises. So for me, I don't know what they're doing at home. Are they actually doing? So obviously, one of the the thing I'm working at is obviously tally monitoring. So if there's some more ideas that you can obviously share, that would be brilliant.
Yeah, you guys have 15 minutes to bring up an idea or the products, okay? So please come forward. I think you're with them, right?
Yeah.
Please enter. Thank you. Second, sports. Where's the sports guy? Stop. Oh, you got it.
But they were hoping that reaching the community center.
Technology, like, I want to thank my team, everybody. Down. Thank you.
Okay, So very short, please present the problem very fast and then the solution. And why do you think it's the right solution? Back it up.
Okay, my name is Hidayat.
Guys, please listen. One big circle to be.
Okay, our problem statement from our team is what we face as a medical practitioner, especially in emergency department, when patient was brought in, we don't know what actually happened at home. If the problem happened already, we don't know how long already it occurred. Again, especially if the patient is unconscious, yes, staying alone, and no family member around. Okay, so when we know what actually happens before the events, before the patient unconscious, so we can actually know what is the main problem and we can treat fast, and also we can trigger the nearest ambulance as fast as possible. So maybe our solution to it is maybe we can develop AI for monitoring the patients. Let's say the vital signs, and also if there is any specific events occur at home, so that particular AI can trigger the nearest ambulance and it fastens the pre-hospital care, and we can prevent. We can treat the patient as early as possible, and as a doctor, we know what actually happens at home, and we can treat specifically what actually is the main problem. Okay.
It's good. It's really feasible. A hint for you, you'll be using neural network. Okay? You're gonna be using neural network if you want to go with AI assistant, because that's the one that will help in accumulating the data and deciding which is the data classification. So I'm just giving you what could be possible, engineering wise. Second, neurosurgery. Go on.
Speak first. One minute, okay?
The problem,
very fast again, and then why you chose that solution, whatever that solution.
So the problem, the pain statement will be, monitoring of patients in the general ward by an understaffed, overworked nurse. So we came up with this, and patients constantly being disturbed. So the solution will be wireless devices which can monitor the blood pressure, temperature, respiratory rate, position, meaning including the gyrometer, accelerometer, everything, and then it is transmitted to workstation. And the gamification point here will be a huge screen where the nurse don't have to squint, and instead of inputting data one by one, it has to be something that we can sweep up, down, pull, drag, move rapidly. And then the third thing is that you must have a trigger point, that once you identify this X, Mr. X is having an issue, it will calculate these things and trigger an alarm which will be sent out to the chief. Remember this for the nurse, it will also trigger the intensivist and the responsible physician.
Nice one. Thank you, sir, for such amazing, actually it's a very good idea with the swiping, and also it's an IoT, so Internet of Things. And I think the first beginning prototype you can use is Raspberry Pi. Start with Raspberry Pi, because you're going to use Wi-Fi. And Wi-Fi will connect you to the tablet, okay? So that's the beginning first. From the IoT side.
Hi everybody. So the problem was obviously monitoring patients at home after an audiologist have given specific exercises for vertigo. So the things I want to look at is if they've done the assessment, if they've done the exercises at home, and obviously if they haven't done it, is there any behavior issue like suicidal and whatnot? So actually there was so much ideas, so I'm gonna like try and see if I can get them in stages. So first of all, we were looking at using a phone, because obviously everybody's attached to the phone. So maybe the exercises using the phone, you know, again, how do we know what they actually do it? So instead of just tick, 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 right? Yes or no. So obviously that kind of exercises will definitely help. Kind of tell me that, okay, this patient actually did the exercises. Okay, and but obviously when we're looking at this, because my patients are mostly 55 and above, so maybe they're not well versed with, you know, smartphones. And of course some places like in rural, even urban, they will own, they won't get 3G. So obviously there's another cool idea using a lock bangle, whereby you can actually know if the patient is, because most of the patients, vertigo is not just one thing, it can be a few exercises, a few reasons. And also we can specialize the treatment using the bangle with movements, and also we can monitor the behavior. So one of the things that we want to avoid is obviously falling, TBI. So if that were to happen, we can actually talk to the patient and obviously send sensors and whatnot. So I think that was cool.
That's a very good platform, especially the fact that you are thinking about offline. So I think you should start having a knowledge base. Yes, you will need a knowledge base where it has almost all the cases possible, so that you can have the application installed wherever they are, and it can still give the right decisions or the right alerts. All right?
To the end user.
Yes, to the end user.
Without connecting back to the
Yes, end. Exactly. So it needs to have an independent knowledge base. All right? So I'm just giving tips. Anyone else? I think we have three, right? Cool. I think this will be the ending of our amazing workshop. Thank you so much for coming. If you want to connect with me, just write to me an email, kat@techverse.xyz, or you can talk to me on Twitter, @chitechnomad. The reason why I say technomad is because I am a nomad at heart, I travel a lot, and I'm a techie, so I'm a technomad and I'm a girl, so she, technomad. Basically, I would like to have your emails as well, please. Let's connect, let's keep connecting. Despite that I am based in Morocco, it does not mean that I'm not here with you mentally. If you want any collaborations or any advice or anything, talk to me. I'm very open to pushing digital health forward.
Argonaut.
Sorry?
Argonaut.
You want Argonaut. I will send you Argonaut. I hope you learned something today. I hope that we have penetrated some thinking cells out there. I hope we inspired you. The reason why MaGIC is there, why TechVerse are also there in Morocco, is the whole point is to get us to get out of the door with something new. All right? Goodbye. Thank you very much.
Having a plug-in was not enough, especially with psychotherapy. You really really need to bring the library because it comes straight from the knowledge of the world. Yes, the bioreflex. That's more of Gamify than ML, because ML you need numerical data. Yeah, but when you gamify something that's about trauma, then you are making a game with the engine and physics engine. Yes, and every tap you have is already calculated on what classification of data. That's how you accumulate medical data since there's a lack of it. Yes, you can tell because there is a relation. There's a formula. There's a formula with your reactivity
of the sweat.
No. It's from your reaction to the given activity. It's a gamification.
Do you use this Dalito?
Yes, because there are assessments in psychiatry which has been done in paper. So what you do is you simulate this test and you make a game because it's the same logic. Oh, by the way, here's my, because I don't have a card, so that's my email.
I have. So what after this, okay, what is your magic motivation? Are you going to open a branch here?
No, we have a partnership because we have a co-working tech hub also in Morocco.
So if we have some solution, can we help with you?
Yeah, why not? Yes, we're very open to teaming up. We're very
sharing open to
there are partners, yeah.
Because my friend is doing a machine learning. She thinks that it comes breast cancer detection.
Yeah, interesting. Yes. She needs a lot of training data.
She has all the data. So, I mean, what's next? I mean, when can she
finish? Yeah.
Okay. Well, can she go to you? Can she come to you?
Why not? Yeah, she has a partnership. Perfect. You'll have my email, write to me, shoot me an email.
For a fellowship or whatever.
Yeah, let's see. We never know. Because we have, if you want, we have partners, you know? So we can see.
So it's dating for
somebody. Yeah, this is one reason why we are connected to Malaysia and Hong Kong at the same time.
I think it's provide funding for this.
Maybe if it's well recommended, for example, if we recommend it to MaGIC, tell them that this is the
problem. Yeah, I just hope so. I just hope you recommend
them. Because it's strategic partnership.
I mean, specifically for this, because they do have some grants funding, but when they mix everything, I mean, this area of health is very I think in a simple system, they have to do a medical check. I mean, it's a QR code. Because when I go into the hospital emergency, you know, people ask me, what's
to do that? And that's the thing of the patient.
I just got with the doctor, and so many doctors said it's security reason.
Yeah.
I just told them we do geofencing only in a certain area. And then I can link them with the license number, right? That's quite important.
They only have made information security, strong IT security, then multiple. But there is FDA, don't forget that. There's always a
rules for that.
Rules for that.
But these are the things, information that I want to expose. I mean, I want the doctors.
You want to describe?
I mean, it's just like allergies, right? I'm like facing problems, right? I mean, it's dangerous if it hits me through my nose.
Yes.
The thing that I'm sensitive with, that I get diarrhea, I can just.
These things are really important.
And they should know that when I have atrial fibrillation, my heart will jump, right? It's because of my thyroid. Maybe I have thyroid storm.
You never know. But the thing is that, for me, in my opinion, is that in order for you to disrupt healthcare, you really need to go very, very slow.
And then it's not easy going.
It's not easy to talk to you. I know. This is why I said it step by step.
Which is, I've been trying to.
But you don't travel like
so. This is where step by step. You go this one, good. Next, good. Not everything. Do not give the whole solution. This is one of them. Very realistic. Do not give the whole solution and say, this is the perfect solution. No. Give one solution that they need, and then after they're good, send them. Until it's
complete.
It might happen, but not eliminate. No. Because this is one of the highest values, the most valuable is the quality of the human. You cannot afford to just eradicate medical doctors. But there is possibility to lower the stress and expand service. Because if you eliminate, then we are putting ourselves in a very difficult situation. Entering manufacturing firms often. You don't want to choose. Despite how consistent and how precise robotics and AI are.
Medication. Sometimes I forgot to take my medications. I just don't need it.
This is the reason why we wanted to show this. It's gamification. Because if we didn't talk about this, we used to not know about it. But now the idea is there. See? And since the idea is there, you have better ideas, right? You see what I mean?
I'm trying to gamify my thyroid results. I have worked together. So it's like clears all my blood results.
Yes. You can give. Make a game out of it. Give it. Look, remember the experience you saw? You just use that.
Even the ECG data, I'm going to get something that I can use. Then I want to get the fund, but it's hard for me to do the ECG interpretations.
An experience.
Gamification is not necessary for real time use during COVID.
As long as it makes experience fun and focused. If you remember what they said,
fun and focused. It's not a fun way into the biomedical life. You have issues, electronics, mechatronics.
Yeah.
But it's not easy to shift.
Sometimes
medical
knowledge. Yeah. How do you do that? Learning medical stuff. Because medical engineering, we have to learn pre-med. We have pre-med. We study in with the
biology, like the A-levels.
Beyond biology. Physiology and beyond. We are second year medical in the eyes of medical engineering. So for example, if I wanted to shift, I will enter second year doctor. It's biomedical from the beginning.
Oh, you are biomedical doctor. How can you do engineering?
Biomedical engineering.
They just started in Malaysia, so now
you're like me. This is why I can speak medical and engineering center. It's the training. They teach you medicine and they teach you engineering. It's hardcore. Manufacturing, mechanical, electronics, software engineering. In 5 years. Can you give me a moment? I drink coffee. I'm tired. So sorry.
But at least I'll get in here.
I'm going to say, 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 same as the mini course.
Time. It's not like waiting 5 hours. You know,